It's great to see you.
Where did you get that picture of me and Benny Hill?
No,
so I don't think I've ever seen that before.
It's really fun. To think it all began back then.
I know.
Oh, goodness me.
I know. It was lovely.
Now, look, Kings of Broadway, this is like a whole new career for you, but I know you love singing. I've seen you singing. It's fantastic.
I do love it.
Yes. I know. So tell me about Kings of Broadway.
Well, it's a tribute to Jerry Herman, Stephen Sondheim, and Julie Stein, and there are lots of us performing. James Bolam and I are doing a comedy number by Jerry Herman.
Oh, that'd be good.
Called Almost Young.
Oh, that would be good. I think
Janie Dee's in it, and Jamie Parker, and it's on Sunday night.
Fantastic.
Yeah, yeah, so it's great. I love it.
The songs that you're singing are the songs that you love anyway.
Well, I'm singing The Party's Over, which is Julie Stein, which I've actually sung before, and a lovely song which I didn't know. That Angela Lansbury sang in a show, I think called Dear World, called I Was Beautiful, and then Jimmy and I are doing a comedy number, and then I think the gang are all doing everything.
Oh, that'd be great.
Together.
That'd be really good, and really
it's
good
great,
at this time
you know,
of year.
Have you ever done musical stuff?
No, I can't sing. I really wish I could.
Makes you feel energised.
I know. Well, I went to see you at the Crazy Cox, because the last time you were in, you told me about this amazing place that you can go to, and I felt as if I was in a Hollywood movie. It was just you and a pianist in this little room.
No, I think it was me and Stefan Bednarczyk. Wasn't it?
We
did a double act.
That's right. But it was just magical.
Good.
It was magical. I loved it. And I love all those songs. And every song you're like, I know that song.
Oh, great.
Oh, it was brilliant.
I like it because I don't want people to get the idea that I stand up and sing all night, because it's about stories, isn't it?
Yes.
There's a lot of comedy in
there. There is. And we get to know you a bit as well.
I think that's what cabaret should be.
Definitely.
I think it should be like you've just had dinner with everybody and you get up and you just sing, say, I'm going to do a bit,
That's great. You've been doing that in New York. You were saying you did that in New York as well.
There's the best. Pretty much the best night of my life. It was, I tell you what was so great, it was to find that I could make Americans laugh, because you don't know whether they're going to like your voice, whether they're going to like you. And they ate us, me and Stefan, they just
Excellent.
Ate us.
Well, that's good to know.
And I'm going on tour now with my cabaret.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
So whereabouts all over?
We're going to Malvern next week. We're going to Nottingham, Manchester, Colchester,
Norwich. We'll stick all the information in our website so that everybody knows.
Good.
So
that's just me and wonderful Jason Carr, who's a musical director.
Do you change it every night? Does it depend on the audience? I know you have
not
a set
lot,
what you're
actually,
going to do, but do things change much?
I mean, I write it, because I think otherwise the comedy doesn't work. You know, if you just, I don't get up and waffle.
No, there's
I mean,
no
but it isn't. I hope it sounds spontaneous. It's not exactly as the script, but I like to make sure that the jokes get said.
Exactly.
You know, it's a lot to remember.
An awful lot. I mean, never mind the songs.
I had a total blackout about when we did it at Crazy Cox. I suddenly said, I have no idea what to say next. But fortunately, Jason was with me, so he's able to tell me.
But that's what's so endearing, because it doesn't matter, in that sort of situation. It's very intimate, everybody's there, and actually that's really endearing.
You know, a lot of actors hate that. They don't like being themselves. I don't know what that makes me, but I actually really... My brothers were very good at that, at getting up and, chatting to crowds of people, and I just love it.
Did you do that as a kid, though? You know the way that...
No,
when I was growing up...
I was the quietest member of the family, because I had three older brothers who were quite extrovert.
But when I was growing up at New Year, especially, everybody had to do their party piece. And everybody had to stand up and do that.
Oh, how horrible.
I know. Well, it was okay, because all
what
the Kellys
did you
were...
Do?
I didn't do anything. I used to run away. But and my mum, I remember my mum stressing over what she had to sing, because all the Kellys were great singers. And it was great. I mean, if you can do it, it's lovely. But if you can, it's torture.
No, I used to stand on with this puffies, and I remember at about the age of five doing impersonations of... an actress called Barbara Mullen, who was on the radio. She's Scottish, wasn't she?
Yes,
on the radio.
Course.
That's all I remember. Yeah, and dancing. I was always dancing about.
Oh, it's brilliant. And of course, you've done so much. Last Tango in Halifax is coming back, isn't it?
I know. Yeah, oh, please, I hope so.
I hope so.
Yeah.
We're starting campaign now.
We haven't been told officially, but I have heard rumours.
It must do.
She's writing it
again. It'd be crazy not to.
Yeah.
And you're going to be working with Orlando Bloom in a movie as well?
I know, it's not a bad life, really, is it?
I just think
I did one day with him last week in Bromley, in a car park in Bromley, and I think the word went round Kent that Orlando Bloom was in the Co-op car park, and suddenly every woman under the age of 50 was there waving an autograph, and he was so sweet. And he did it. He signed everybody's autograph. He's a very nice young man, actually.
Good, good. Well, if he gets your approval, he must be all right. He's all right by me.